If you want to charge your Goal Zero Yeti 1000 or equivalent lithium battery pack from Goal Zero, you have two options. You can charge from solar or through the alternator. In this van, in our Sprinter, we don't have solar at all. So our alternative is to use our alternator to power the Yeti. The Goal Zero website offers a Yeti Link expansion module for $400 US. And you figure, okay, this is great. Let's try to buy this. And you scroll down, scroll down, scroll down. And they say the Yeti Link car charging kit is currently unavailable. Our engineers are working on revamping the kit for an even better vehicle integration experience. Check back for a new and improved Yeti Car Link charging kit this spring. So what can we do? I don't have solar and the kit's not available. So even if the kit was available and I've got an MPPT controller from Goal Zero in this section here, I would have to remove the one that would go in here and then replace it with the Yeti Car Link. And a lot of people don't want to do that because it's more efficient than the current PWM input. So what I did about half a year ago was purchase a pre-made cable with the negative and positive Anderson power pole connectors, and I connected to my own 10 gauge wiring. And what this does is you plug it in into the PWM controller as an input, and the input allows for 15 volts to 22 volt range. So that's great for solar panels. So pretend this goes all the way up to my roof, to my solar panel with MC4 connectors, etc. Now I can power my Yeti, but I don't have solar power. So what I did was purchase a Victron Orion isolated DC to DC converter. So let me show you. So this is the Orion TR Smart 12 volt to 24 volt 15 amp isolated DC to DC charger. What I've got at the bottom here are two wires, 8 gauge, that go all the way underneath my seat to the battery that's located under my feet in the Sprinter. These two cables go to the Anderson power plug that I just showed you a minute ago. So this is what it looks like. I've mounted it behind the car seat, behind the driver's seat here. And the nice thing is the engine is off right now. This is not powering my Goal Zero right now because the engine is off. So we'll go switch on the van. Now let's go back and see the power going into the Yeti. So we're in the back of the van right now. I've got the Anderson power pole plugged in. Input is currently zero. And there's an app called Victron Connect. Let's go into Victron Connect. So here I've got the Orion Smart isolated. Click on that. It's on power supply mode, but it's disabled because I've disabled it for this demonstration. I've got the function as power supply, charger enabled, and the output voltage I've set to 20 volts. And there's a lower voltage, which I'll go into in a sec. Watch the power go up. I'm charging now from the van through my alternator, through the Victron Orion, into the Goal Zero at 340 or so watts. It's like having three 100 watt solar panels above my roof. Sometimes this thing buzzes, I have no idea why, probably loose connection. It goes away after it's warm. But you see, this charges. So if I drive and it goes 350 watts or so per hour, I can charge this thing in a couple hours. If it rains a lot, like it does here in Vancouver, normally you wouldn't get any solar. But if I'm driving just to and from Home Depot, or running errands, or going on a long trip, I can supply power to my Yeti 1000. So let's take a look what these things mean here. Let's set this up a little bit better. If you can see this, there's an input voltage lockout, and for my Sprinter, it's for a Euro 6 alternator. The lockout voltage is at 13.2 volts. So if the battery goes below 13.2 volts, then the Orion will switch off. If it's above 13.4 volts, meaning that it's the engine is on, the alternator is supplying current, this thing will automatically switch on. Power supply mode, it shows a voltage of 13.6 volts. Output voltage is kept constant and current limited to the configured values on the settings page. So this Orion can go from 20 volts all the way up to 30 volts. If you do more than 22 volts, you can damage the Yeti. So make sure you set this up for 20 volts or 22, but I've just gone a little bit lower than the maximum. You see, it's still charging 325, depending on how fast the alternator's turning and how much it's generating. Input is coming in. This is without solar. So imagine if you did have solar and you put your MPPT controller here, you could double the amount of power going into your Yeti. So this works really well. I've had this almost 6 months now. Installed this around August of 2020. It's January 2021 now. This works really well. Goes all the way up to about 95% or so. This battery is about 3.5 years old. So the cost of the Victron is $263 on Amazon in the States. And this particular version of the Victron TR Smart Charger has an internally fused charger, so you don't need to have a fuse at the battery from the Sprinter. The wire here, as I mentioned earlier, is 8 gauge that goes to the Sprinter battery. This wiring here is 10 gauge, and this is the output to the Yeti. And I would have used 8 gauge just to be on the safe side, but 10 gauge is fine, and that's all they had in stock at the time. I've only got 6 feet runs of the cabling, so that's fine for 15 amps of current going through there without much of a voltage drop. So this is what it looks like. You see, I took two bolts, bolted it to the seat pedestal. Very simple to install. This does get hot, so keep any curtains away. I've got a blackout curtain for the van here. I keep this hanging pretty close, but far enough away when I drive, so it's not affected. Another advantage of going with the Orion from Victron is that it's not Goal Zero proprietary specific, so this can be used to charge 24 volt batteries, lithium batteries, or AGM batteries, so it gives you a lot more flexibility in the future. If I bought the Yeti Car Link, if it became available, I would be stuck with the Goal Zero. Mind you, the Goal Zero is a very good product. I'm really happy with it. This will also charge a number of different Yeti lithium products. I've put a link in the description below of all the different types of battery packs that are out there that are more popular. The Blue Yeti, the iEnergy Kodiak, and I'll show you which ones actually will work and get charged by this alternator solution here. So take a look at the description below. We've got a website link as well that details the entire installation and gives you more hints and tips as well. So I hope this helps. This is a pretty cool idea that I've struggled to figure out, and I figure I share this out with you. If you like this kind of content, press the like button. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, I have more type of videos like this. Thanks very much for watching. Appreciate it. Have a great day. Bye-bye.